All right, time for round four. Somehow we've kept this hand. I'm not sure how that happened, but I think the reason that I ended up keeping this particular hand is that on four, Perilous Vault is the card you want, and I think that it's worth trying this, though. Turn two, Seeker of the Ways. Mildly annoying. Still have drawn a dissolve now, so you've got a turn three dissolve, turn four, Perilous Vault, and turn five, Jace's Ingenuity, or blow up Perilous Vault. And didn't get Rabble Mastered, so I actually like the position I'm in right now. Playing against what looks like either Jeskai, but the Jeskai decks more often feature tokens than anything else these days, so wouldn't be surprised if there were some tokens. Didn't do anything else. Interesting. I'm just gonna play Perilous Vault here. I feel like it's better to just play Perilous Vault than it is to keep up Dissolve, because what can my opponent do? Play Hushwind Griff into my Perilous Vault. Interesting. I'm gonna get hit down to 13 here. Unless my opponent has a spell. The question is, do I blow up Perilous Vault next turn, or do I do something else? I'm gonna keep playing lands that aren't fetch lands. I think I might blow up Perilous Vault on the 13. I really don't want to get burned out. And my opponent didn't play any other threats earlier when they could have, so I guess they didn't play a land for a turn. All right, well, I'm just blowing up Perilous Vault here. I think even if my opponent plays a threat and then I end up having to use Jace's Ingenuity to find an answer, I still take less damage. All right. No, Chandra is annoying. I will give you that. I'm gonna keep up Dissolve, put Bioblade on the bottom, and hope to find a hero's downfall. I'm not worried about counters, so which is why I'm not main phasing Jace's Ingenuity. Much rather have my own counters up if I need to. I kind of expect Chandra to be zeroed, but nope, it's just plussing. All right, my opponent might just be on the straight burn plan. It has like very few lands, tons of spells. I could just tap out for Jace's Ingenuity and just take double lightning strike down to five or something like that, which I wouldn't love, but I certainly have to play the Ingenuity here. I'm expecting to get stoked, or at the very least. I drew Hero's Downfall. Let's see. Stopping my opponent's upkeep. I have six mana, so I'm going to play Temple as my seventh. Put Dismal Backer on the bottom, because I figure I can cast Hero's Downfall, and yeah, you know what? I'd actually rather discard here. I think I'm going to discard a Swamp. Stoke the flames. All right, now I guess I just do this now. So I'm gonna Hero's Downfall to Chandra, and I'm gonna dissolve the Stoke. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna take the hitter off Stoke. If my opponent had tons of burn, I think they would have thrown it at me when I was tapped out. So even though Stoke is one of the bigger burn spells, I feel like I'll have an opportunity to use this dissolve effectively. Mantis Rider. All right, that I will allow. Bioblade it up. All right, so playing against kind of standard Jeskai. Still could have tokens. You never know. And I'm at seven, so I'm a Lightning Strike and a Stoke away from dying. Don't really like Seeker, but I don't think I want to play Vault here. I think I'm gonna plan on. Let's see, if I cast Dissolve and I sack Delta, if I just cast Dissolve, that's enough to play Dig Through Time, or even without playing Dissolve. Alright, so I'm just going to play Urborg. That way, next turn, if I play Delta, I can have it available for black mana without sacrificing it if I need to. Alright, Mantis Rider, I will Dissolve. Keeping up Dig. Silence the Believers, I guess I'll put it on top, even though I don't think I really want to dig into it, just because, it's at the very least a way to kill this Seeker of the Way. I kind of expect a Lightning Strike here. Alright, no Lightning Strike. Interesting. So, opponent's only got two cards in hand now, though, so maybe they're just not great. I don't think my opponent's playing Chain to the Rocks with that mana base over there. But if they had a Lightning Strike, they really would want to cast it there. I guess actually the extra damage doesn't matter too much. Either if I go down to 5, now I'm 2 burn spells away from dying. Alright, so here comes... Oh, Jeskai Charm. Well, that would have been lethal, actually. Alright, I want Hero's Downfall and I want Negate. And I think that's better than taking anything else here. I'm going to Hero's Downfall the Secret Boy since I'm dead to it regardless. And then I'm going to play... I guess I'll play a land and I'll play a Perilous Vault, leaving the gate up. Alright, so if my opponent has a Mantis Rider, then I do die. But I don't die to random burn spells. No, Mantis Rider. No, this is Stoke. Or Chandra. Chandra I can also play around. Alright, hope my opponent's last card is not Lightning Strike. Nope, it's Temple of Epiphany, and let's take a look. Looks like my opponent put a card on the bottom. Good to know. Alright, I think I interpreted the signs here. Since I can hopefully find a dissolve. Let's see. Really wouldn't mind a Pearl Lake Ancient or a Dig Through Time to just draw them all. Can't quite crack Perilous Vault, but if I find a Hero's Downfall or something, then I can be the leg for Mantis Rider. I'm still just going to put Bioblade on the... Actually, I'm going to put Bioblade on the top and then Perilous Vault on the top and draw 4. I was hoping to draw a Counterspell, but... Alright, let's play Radiant Fountain. And pass the turn with Silence the Believers and Bioblade up. If I knew I was drawing Silence, probably wouldn't have taken these particular cards. Alright, I don't mind Jason Genesee. So I can cast... I'm going to play Dismal Backwater so I don't get Lightning Struck to death. And I'm going to hold off on casting Ashiok because I want to be able to Jace's Ingenuity into a Dissolve. Actually, I think I should have Jace's Ingenuity on upkeep because now I'm going to do it end of turn, and if my opponent has Stoke the Flames, then I actually do die. It's going to be hard to survive this Dig Through Time. At least Lightning Strike doesn't kill me if they're even playing that. Alright. Pretty good, chance of just dying here. Let's see what happens. Well, my opponent casts Dig Through Time and let Jason Genuity resolve, and I do 2 counterspells, so I'm actually feeling pretty good about this somehow. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I'm just going to keep playing lands, and I'm just not going to play Ashiok. Ashiok doesn't do anything here. Actually, I'm probably just going to discard Ashiok. Since I want to play Pearl Lake Ancient, and because I can play Pearl Lake Ancient and still have Dissolve and Negate up. And I do have to start killing my opponent at some point. Alright. Pearl Lake Ancient. 2 counter spells at the ready. Opponent has 2 cards in hand, and not that many cards are lethal. Jeskai Charm is. I guess I'll negate that. Negate at this point is worse than Dissolve because I have lots and lots of mana. So could my opponent have killed me? It looks like my opponent could have killed me in response to the Jace's Ingenuity and just didn't. Alright, well, I'll take that. Countered them both. Actually, I'm putting Dismal Backwater on top. Though, actually, I didn't need to do that because I have a Pearl Lake Ancient. Good point. Alright, so, because now what I want to do is tap these for mana and then just cast Pearl Lake Ancient. This is what I should have... So basically I should have put Dismal Backwater on the bottom because I already had access to it, but that's alright. Because now I get to replay Radiant Fountain and just go off. Basically getting an extra 2 life a turn until I could no longer die. So, looks like traditional Jeskai. I definitely don't want Ashiok there. I do like Prognostic Sphinx, though. I do like Bioblade. I like Hero's Downfall. Perilous Vault's actually fairly weak. I don't love Thoughtseize a ton, but post-board it actually probably gets a little better than it would have been pre-board. Murkluk is actually decent, I think. It's not, like, insane, but I think it's better because it threatens Chandra. It interacts better with Seeker than Perilous Vault does. Mantis Rider is just so cheap, and I don't really want to use Perilous Vault to destroy it, so... I think I want Liliana. A couple Thoughtseize. I don't want to overload on Thoughtseize, but a couple seems okay.